agentic AI in the enterprise. What is the impact from agentic AI? How you can make it successful? And I'm here with Maxim Loffe. You are the Global Intelligence Automation Lead at Wesco. And we're here at UiPath Forward, number 7 already in Las Vegas. Welcome, and it's great to have you over here.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. Excited to be here.
Let's start from where you are, because agentic is more a concept, which step by step will be rolled out into the market. Where are you now to have an understanding how to move to agentic as the next step?
From the where we are today, we are a fairly large enterprise automation program. We do a lot of unattended automations. We have a lot of bots in production. We are a global company. The bots are present for every geography, every functional area, you name it, we have it there. Sales, operations, supply chain, what have you. And of course, just like anywhere else, you have very rigid tasks that are very easy to automate. And you have judgment calls, and you have all kinds of things. And we became extremely good at isolating the tactical stuff that can be automatable to the from the decision making, from the judgment calls, and have a lot of orchestration to send things back and forth. So the human in the loop is doing the judgment, and the robots do what they do the best.
So if we look to the type of automation, is it more the repetitive task, or is it already the next level with document reading, document understanding? Where are you now?
It's all of the above. To us, the document reading, document understanding could become a real part of the repetitive task. Your classic invoice processing is one of those. It could also become full of judgment calls, and the judgment calls could come in all form and shape. You can read the document, and any purchase order we receive doesn't necessarily say where do you fulfill it from. As a global distributor with hundreds and thousands of locations, that's a judgment right there.
And what's now the next step to move the first step into the agentic AI?
Well, again, with orchestration platform already available, we have a ton of unattended automation, this human in the loop. It could be via email, it could be we are more of an attended setup, could be a chatbot, whatever it is. The journey there is taking out those judgments one by one and replacing it with agentic, where we are comfortable with it, where technology is ready for it, and where users are ready to give up that task. And each one of those has to be taken into consideration.
And you talk about judgment, you mean human judgment. You want to automate, let's say, out
exactly.
of the process.
Right.
And how do you define whether it's ready to be automated or whether you still want to have the human judgment?
From the change management perspective, we always want the idea to come from the business. We can educate them. One of the biggest things that we do in VSK is educate the users. My goal is to reach out to, we have 20,000 employees, any desk employee, any employee that uses the computer. I want to reach out to them periodically, reminding the tech. And then I want to make sure that we take that technology and tell the users, okay, where do you want it? How do you want it to help you out? And then the user decides if they're ready for it.
And one of the aspects of agentic AI is autonomous systems where they can work with different agents and humans. So what's the autonomous part where you are working on right now?
A lot of that has to do with ingestion, removing the human from the trivial decision making. That's easy. A lot of people don't want to do it anyways. Mm-hmm. It could be the item matching, it could be finding the right supplier, it could be judgment calls that are easy for humans to give up. We're going to start there. We're not necessarily looking at agentic full autonomous tasks or processes. We're saying, what can we make autonomous right now with the technology and with the user comfort level? As technology matures, as UiPath releases more, we should be able to take more and more and one step at a time to get into the agentic world.
And one part of the agentic is to use real-time data. Especially in the supply chain, real-time data is crucial. Do you have already examples where you use real-time data for the actions that you've automated?
We may not have anything automated immediately that comes to mind with real-time data, but as real-time as we try to do, a lot of events could be triggered by a service now. A ticket gets created, a ticket goes to somebody. Daniel used an example of L1 support. We do elements of that as well. And it works extremely well, and we just got a feedback over the weekend from one of the users on the ticket being resolved super fast, super efficiently. The user had no idea that it was the automation that resolved the ticket. And this kind of things is where change management is trivial. Everybody wants this to happen.
Yeah. And one of the key aspects from Agentic is large language models and document reading, document understanding. What kind of examples are you working on to move in that direction?
It's a journey as well. Part of it is, do we have the documents regularly available? Part of it, do we trust the document? Part of it, are we ready with a trust level and security? There are a lot of steps, a lot of checkboxes to be checked before we can go there. And we're taking it one step at a time, but we do have a fair amount of contracts, purchase orders that you would think would be same, more structured than they are. This type of documents become our first targets, but that's just the beginning.
And what kind of impact will Agentic AI have for your organization, from a business, from an automation perspective? What do you expect in 1 or 2 years from now?
Well, there are some obvious things, productivity improvement. Nobody will argue with that one, but there is also ability to unlock new revenue, ability to over-service the customer. As a wholesale distributor, we exist because we can do one of things that nobody else will do for our customers. If we can get the agents to that work, one thing, we can do more of them. For another, we can do them with a reasonable cost. So it's not cost prohibitive to offer this value-add services.
Maxim, great insights of the impact of AI, agentic AI. And I love what you're working on, and keep me posted from what's happening. And thank you for watching here from Las Vegas, from UiPath 4 or 7. Thanks for watching.
Thank you. Bye. Thanks for having me.